Steve Dotto here. I'm glad you're joining us today. Today, we're continuing our journey towards 100,000 subscribers, and we're going to stay in the video space for this episode. Last episode, we talked about lighting, and I gave you all the feedback on improving the quality of lighting that I have here in my home studio. Well, today, I want to take on the camera settings, adjusting the color settings of the camera so that we can go from just good light to great quality video out of just a simple high-definition webcam. Now, as soon as I posted the last video on lighting, I got a lot of response from people that were giving me lots of advice in different aspects. And I actually reached out kind of and asked for advice, saying, if you had any suggestions for me. And one of the subscribers of our show contacted me and said, Steve, I'm willing to help you out. I'm a video professional. And so I took Aaron Johnson up on his offer. He's recently moved to Vancouver from New Zealand. Before that, Bellingham, Washington. Aaron, are you there?
Hello.
Hey, how are you doing?
Yeah, doing great. Doing great.
Good. I have to thank you. So yesterday, Aaron and I walked through configuring my camera. Aaron's a broadcast professional. He's got vast experience in audio and video. And so you basically helped me tune the camera and kind of bring it into just adjust the color calibration so that the video looks a lot better. I have to thank you for that. So let's recreate that and walk through the process that we went through.
All right.
Okay. So now the camera that I have is the Logitech C920, which is, I think, around $120, maybe $140 retail. It's probably the best of the high-definition webcams that are consumer-focused. And in the Windows world, it's got a great set of tools. It's got a great driver that allows you to adjust everything from color to allowing it to focus and all sorts of things. On the Mac, they've also got drivers for it, but they're pretty anemic. So I found a tool called Webcam Settings, which was $8 or $9 in the Apple Store, and I installed it. And so Aaron and I are going to kind of walk through the settings, or walk through the decision points that you make after you've set up your lighting as you configure your video. And now I will point out that the video today is going to be somewhat more choppy. That's because we're asking the resources that I have here on my little editing computer here to do so much more than normal. So Aaron and I are on a Skype call. I'm screen sharing with Aaron so that he can see the color, and I'm trying to record it all at the same time. And that's just, it's kind of overtaxing the capabilities of my, now I think, 5-year-old iMac a little bit. So if the video is a little bit choppy, you'll just have to bear with me. The key here, though, is not the smoothness of the video. It's the color that we're going to see. It's the image that we're going to see, and you should get a really good idea of that from this video. So Aaron, you basically agree with me, don't you, as far as setting up the hierarchy of for this type of screencasting work? Number one is to make sure your audio setup is great. Number two would be setting up your lighting. And the third thing you've got to really concentrate on is the camera and the color. Do you agree with that hierarchy?
Yeah, completely agree with that. I mean, audio first and foremost, right? If people can't hear you, or, you know, and I get frustrated with poor videos that I see on YouTube where people haven't taken the time to invest, you know, getting proper audio setups, you know, to do their shows. And it's
irritating. It's almost grating. And that's not for all video, you know, viral video that's shot in the field, you know, there are issues around that. But if you're trying to teach somebody something, if you're trying to communicate a message, it really behooves you to make sure your audio is awesome first and foremost, because people often, even when they're watching YouTube, they're not watching the video. They're listening to it almost as a podcast and then referring to the screen from time to time. So the audio is number one. But today we're talking video. So when we first, let's kind of walk through what we started with. And we've got the camera set up right now to the default settings. Mm-hmm. So the video looks the way it did after I configured the new lights. It was a dramatic improvement, but it's still not very good, is it?
Mm-hmm. But the key is you need to have good lighting.
Yes.
So, you know, you can make all the adjustments in the world, but if you don't have good lighting, it's not going to look good.
So we've got the good lighting set up, and it was an inexpensive kit. I've got links to it on the website so people can take a look. It's not expensive to set up decent lighting. It was around $100 is what I spent on this lighting kit, which is just fine. And it's an investment well worth making, I would say. Now, the one thing that we noticed, we had a lot of comments on in the community, was even though I'd fixed the lighting, that when I was moving my head back and forth or when I was doing things on the computer screen, the color was shifting. It was changing back and forth. You identified that in our very first conversation, and you said to me what?
Turn off the auto white balance.
So if we take a look here at the webcam settings panel, so this is what we're going to work our way through is all of these different settings. This auto white balance is it was the culprit in the color shifting. And the reason it was shifting so much in the last video I created is because as I went from dark screen to light screen, actually the color that was being reflected back to me from the monitor was changing the white balance and the camera was adapting. It was doing what it was supposed to do, right?
Yeah, exactly. It's trying to make sure the whites stay white and... You know, and it's not smart enough, in the sense when it's in auto mode, to know what's skin tone, what's a background, you know, and all that fun stuff. So that's why we need to get in here and adjust it.
So as soon as I turn that off, how do we go about, what's the best way to adjust it? Now, as soon as I turn it off, it even got uglier. Holy cow. We really managed to make it worse. So when we did TV all the time, they were always looking for this. They were always looking for a piece of white paper to hold up in front of the camera. Mm-hmm. And that's still the best way to do things, right?
Yes, exactly. So the one thing I just saw you when you held up your paper. The other thing we need to do before we get done with this white balance is you need to put that auto exposure into manual mode because that'll adjust your white balance as well.
Okay, so I've set that as well into manual mode. Okay, so now we can go and we can adjust the white balance. Mm-hmm. And now in the TV studio, they used to do it with a scope that actually look at the scope. But we don't have to do that. We can just adjust it by trying to change that whatever that color there is,
yep.
And trying to make it white. Is that close?
Yeah. Well, no. I take it down just a little bit.
And it's a little bit too much.
It looks a little too yellow.
Yellow.
Yeah.
A little jaundiced. And a little bit lower. How's that?
Yeah, right about there. Right in the middle of the road.
Okay. Yeah, so that's okay. So now we've set the white balance, and we don't want to turn that back on. Now, the cool thing is we'll be able to save this as a profile so that we don't have to go back and do these settings each time we set up the camera. We can save them as a preset. As a profile. So once we set up the white balance to start, that gives us a base to work from. What's the next stage?
All right, well, let's have a look at that exposure time.
Okay, what does exposure time do for us?
That's just the amount of refreshing and the amount of time the lens is open. So
okay. So and with all of these things in a slider like this, if you don't know what it does, slide it around and see what happens, right?
Yeah.
So there I've slid it up and it just washes me out completely. So yeah. We probably don't want to change it too much from down there. Now, it looks like it's doing almost the same thing as a brightness would do. Am I wrong?
Yeah. I mean, I don't get exactly what they're meaning by exposure time because it could be a number of different things that it could be adjusting. But, you know, like you said, you know, if you don't know what it is, slide it around and see what it does.
Okay. So do you think that's good there? That looks pretty good to me.
It's a little bright, but, you know, we'll adjust the gain and we'll see what we come up with.
If I turn the gain up,
mm-hmm.
I get, again, brighter.
Mm-hmm.
If I turn the gain down.
There we go. A lot less noisy. There we go.
Okay. Does that look good to you?
Yeah. That's looking good.
Okay. Now, brightness?
Yeah.
Overall?
I'm kind of happy with the brightness level, to be honest.
It's not bad. Yeah, I found it when we were in the auto mode, it was washed out. It was too bright. But now that we've set up the exposure time and the gain a little bit, and adjusting just the white balance has changed to me the brightness a fair bit.
Yep.
Okay. So once you set those first settings, you're getting close to where you want to be. Now let's go into the advanced settings and see what the advanced ones are. Mm-hmm. Now, this power line, this is really for international distribution of any product. It's changing the frequency of the camera. So it's really, if you're in North America, 60 hertz. If you're elsewhere in the world, it's probably going to be 50 hertz.
Yes,
right?
and that's dependent on the voltage that comes out of your wall socket. So it's, there's really, really long articles online if you want to read all about that.
I don't want to do all that. Next thing we want to look at is the backlight compensation. Now, in the lighting kit that I set up, it's a three-point lighting system. It's got two umbrella lights, and then it's got, they call it a rim light or a backlight. Mm-hmm. And I've got that set up against the wall behind me. Mm-hmm. Now, for people that don't know or are kind of neophytes to lighting, the light against the back wall will basically remove me from the background. It makes me stand out and gives me kind of depth of field as far as the image is concerned. Now, if I didn't have a light behind me, would I then use that backlight compensation?
I mean, it's okay. I mean, like, yeah, turn it on there and, you know, it's washed everything out. And it's,
yes.
Because it's trying to separate you from the background. But The key is you know, you want that bit of light in the background to separate you, you know, so you're not become one part of the wall. So
I guess if you're in a difficult environment too, where you've got a lot of light behind you, like you are backlit, like in a you know, with a camera when you're taking a picture and the light source is behind, you might play with that at that point there, and it might change things, and it might allow the foreground image to be pop out a little bit more if you've got too much light behind you.
Yes.
That might work there. Okay. Now, the focus is another one of the auto tools. Now, I'm going to turn it off. I think these cameras are kind of set for infinite focus when it's down to zero, and then as you move it up, it starts to actually change where it's focusing. Yeah. And so this might be a good look for me. You know, if I do this, I don't have to worry about makeup or anything like this. It's like having the Vaseline on the lens a bit. But I'm going to leave that turned off because just like I don't like the auto white balance changing, being kind of distracting as we're speaking, I don't like it when cameras try and focus as you're moving in and out. I'd rather be slightly out of focus by a physical move and then kind of get back to my home position than have the camera trying to catch up constantly, have that zooming in and out. We all know that, especially with video cameras or DSLRs that people have in autofocus. If they're using those for feed, we see lots of the camera. You know, you can almost hear the motor running, can't you?
Yeah.
And the other, again, this isn't anything to do with the lighting, but this has to do with the composition is the zoom. And I like the fact that I can zoom in a little bit on the image here and just kind of frame myself a little bit better. Mm-hmm. And now you have to be careful with your headroom and stuff when you do this because holding a position. Now, I sit on a ball chair, so I tend to bounce a little bit. And sometimes I pop in and out of frame. And I also notice often when I'm recording my demo, if I'm too tight, that my chin drops below the horizon of the video. So that's something you have to be a little bit careful of. But you can play with that framing and composition here.
Yeah.
And the LED is just there's a little tally light on the camera telling me when it's recording, and it's just turns on, and it's like kind of like the on air light, and that's really all that we need to do, isn't it?
Yeah,
that's pretty much the settings.
You've zoomed in, you've done all this stuff. I'd still check my white balance. I'd still hold up my little white piece of paper and
let's do that.
Make sure it's still white. Yeah.
Still looks pretty white to me.
Still looks pretty white. I mean, and your skin tone's fine. You know, for people that, you know, don't have a buddy or anything, you know, to help them adjust it, I'd recommend just getting a mirror and having it next to your monitor while you're
doing
this.
That's a great tip. I never thought of that. So just comparing it to make it so that what you're seeing is what the camera sees.
Yes.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
Okay, without being too artsy. Now, the next thing that you want to do is you want to save the profile. And I'm going to save this as our little demo. And so that allows me to then load this profile in and save. And you could have different profiles. Like I've got in my office here, we're shooting on a rainy day today. And I don't have a lot of light coming in, but I've got a fairly reasonably sized window with shutters kind of over it here. But if it's a sunny day and I notice that looks a little bit different, I might tweak my settings, save those settings as sunny day settings so I know. And then also, if I'm shooting at night and I find it maybe is a little bit dark, I might tweak my settings at night too. Mm-hmm. And then I've got a couple of different profiles that I can quickly go back to. So I'm not spending time configuring the camera each and every time. And I'm spending more time recording content and less time setting up my gear. Does that sound reasonable?
Yeah, no. I'm all about presets in that way.
So let's see what we've got here. So I've got this profile. So let's take a look. So this was the camera default. Let's go back to it. Mm-hmm. And I think everybody can now see immediately that is pretty bad. But when you think about where I came from, it's actually pretty good, but it's pretty bad compared to where we can get to. And let's compare, because this is something that I wonder about. So this is the one that we just did now, our little demo. And let's compare that to what you and I set up yesterday, which is called Aaron's profile. It's kind of like Annie's song. There we go. Pretty similar. A little. Actually, I think we did a little better job yesterday, don't you?
Well, yeah.
Just it's like we had a little more time and we weren't trying to record and didn't have all the lag on the computer and stuff. But there we are. Yeah, I like the one that we set up there. Mm-hmm. What do you like better?
Yeah, I like it. I like the zoom out just a little bit more. It's, you know, not having it as tight.
Color looks a little more natural to me. Yeah, that's good. Aaron, I got to thank you so much for helping me out here. It's been great. And if anybody in the British Columbia area is looking for a top-notch broadcast professional. Aaron, you're looking for a job, aren't you?
Yes, I am at the moment, yeah.
I hate to embarrass you, but if there is one out there, drop me a note and I'll put you in touch with Aaron. He's a great guy. He's certainly knowledgeable. And really, video's your strength, but audio is your passion. You love sound,
yes.
Don't you?
Yes, well, good. Any media format, how about that?
Well, next, when we do another one of these videos, we start talking about sound systems and we start talking about mics and setup, maybe we'll have another conversation if you have time.
Sounds great.
I appreciate it. And with that, I'm going to wrap things up. Remember, please subscribe to our channel. We are on a journey to 100,000 subscribers, and for that, we need you. And join in the conversation. Down below here, if you're on YouTube, down below is a active community that's asking questions and answering questions. So if you have comments or questions, please join in the conversation. We're all on a journey of learning about this whole business of YouTube publishing. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks so much for spending time with me today.